Ancio now working the body against the ropes. And that's the second time that Rafael has been cautioned for holding down Andrew Concio.
What they do, silk screen is what they do, and if you want a shirt from the Desert Showdown, a cap or a split top.
Hard right hand once again. Concio just mercifully coming in, finding his spot, and that'll wrap up this round. Round number two comes to a close. That'll give us an opportunity to say a special thanks to Dan I of All Star Entertainment Productions for his continuing support of amateur boxing and the third annual Desert Showdown. It's always great when someone from the community steps up to help the kids out for such a great cause. Much rather they fight in the ring than on the streets. And that's been the success of amateur boxing. And we are proud to continue that tradition. Over in the red corner, Andrew Concio out of Blythe is doing pretty much everything by the book, going for the points, not looking for the big knockdown or knockout. A very skilled boxer is Andrew Concio in this division. Over in the blue corner, Rafael Villavazo from Stockton is doing a great job, but he's doing it in reverse. He's continually being pushed by Concio. Somebody has to go backwards, but Villavazo has done it all night long, and maybe that's his tactic to get Andrew Concio a little closer. But so far, Concio has been wise to stay out of that, and then as soon as I say that, Villavazo catches him with a right hook. And again, Concio with the pressure, and then takes two short little jabs from Villavazo, comes back with a hard left of his own. But Concio will not back down. He continues to march forward and pressure Villavazo, and then catches him with a left hook, and that's going to result in another standing eight count. Rafael Villavazo, the victim of a sharp left hand from Concio, is back underway now. And responding, Villavazo, for to his own credit, did not appear hurt by that. It was just the fact that it was a solid shot. And the referee, Rick Lee, wanted to give him a little bit of time to recover from it. And now, Villavazo working his way out of the corner again, as he's done so well tonight, lands a hard left hand to Concio. And now it's Concio back in the ring. So Lee is trying, or Villavazo rather, is trying to reverse tactics. And now is trying to push Concio, but Concio continues to come forward, walks right into a jab from Villavazo. And this is the third and final round of the bout. Villavazo is now changing the game, and it seems to be working for him. And Concio continuing the pressure, so it's not like Concio thinks he has this fight and is backing down or playing defensively. These are tough exchanges going on now here in the middle. And a sharp uppercut rocks the head of Villavazo, and now a left is continually landing, albeit with not a lot of power on it. And that will be the end of a fight, a pretty hard-fought battle towards the end of the third round, so a good job for both of these open-class fighters. Andrew Concio out of Blythe and Rafael Villavazo out of Stockton Police Activity League. 125-pound battle of 15 and 16-year-olds in the open category. It's a semifinal fight, and we will find out who will be going to the finals. And we'll get to see the ring girls one more day. You're watching the Carl's Jr. Time Warner Cable Game of the Week from Trump 29 Casino, and we will be right back right after this. DesertNetwork.com, the Valley's online search engine, welcomes you to the 21st century. At DesertNetwork.com, quickly search and find the Valley's top businesses, retail stores, and restaurants, large and small, well-known and not so well-known. Easily search for product and service information, company websites, location maps, even instant printable coupons and more. Point, click, found, DesertNetwork.com.
The Thermal Boxing Club and Desert Showdown would like to thank Jessa Printing for their support of amateur boxing, always leaving a lasting impression. At Jessa Printing, it's not just ink on paper. It's a total package from concept to completion. Jessa Printing, proud sponsor of the 2004 Desert Showdown.
Welcome back to the Carl's Jr. Time Warner Cable Game of the Week from the Spotlight Showroom at Trump 29 Casino. Rob Osmond with you with All-Star Entertainment Productions. About to find out the latest winner in this third annual Desert Showdown at the 125-pound level for 15 and 16-year-olds. Open category. And this is a semifinal, so we'll find out in just a moment who will be going to the finals. Out of the red corner, Andrew Concio from Blythe against Rafael Villavazo from Stockton Police Activity Leagues. And for all unofficial tabulations, it would appear that Andrew Concio will have a ticket to the finals. And that announcement should be forthcoming. A lot of people on hand watching this fight, as it has serious implications for what will happen at the finals. In any minute now, we're going to find out exactly who that will be. We have three rings going on at one time. And the crowds continue to build. Boxers getting ready to go. And boxers who have recently completed in these three rings that are going on simultaneously.
Okay, I've been told that we do have a decision.
And now I hear the decision is just about ready to come down. So we'll find out if Andrew Concio will advance into the finals. He's out of the red corner.
Is standing in the red corner.
And that is indeed. On the Carl's Jr. Time Warner Cable Game of the Week. We will take a quick break and come back for more of the third annual Desert Showdown from Trump 29 Casino right after these messages.
Truck shoppers, From Dodge is California's number one heavy-duty truck dealer. Right now, we're overstocked with our largest inventory ever. And now's your opportunity to save like never before. We need to make every possible deal, so let us go to work for you. From is selling every new 05 Ram quad cab for just $17,995. You save nearly $10,000. We're number one, and we intend to stay number one. From Dodge, off the 15 freeway at the 2nd Street exit in Norco. Call 1-888-50-DODGE.
It's the one sure thing in amateur boxing. No matter how hard the kids train in the gym, only one can win. Make no mistake about it, both boxers are winners, but only one will have his hand raised at the end of the fight. Making that determination falls under the watchful eyes of the referees and ringside judges, all of whom have trained extensively under the professional guidance of USA Amateur Boxing. While becoming an Olympic or professional fighter may be the goal of each of the young boxers, the sole purpose of the officials is clear.
We're not so interested in creating world champions or Olympic champions. We're here to get these kids off the street. A lot of the kids are at risk, and we want them to have a sport that they can participate in, and they can learn some discipline. The sport teaches them a lot of discipline. There is no off-season in amateur boxing. They could take these skills and apply them to college or to other things. Life.
The difference between amateur and professional boxing is broader than most people think. In professional boxing, the referees look for the big, hard punches and knockdowns. Amateurs look for more of the technique and ability.
In pro boxing, you see the scoring. A knockdown is given more weight than any other punch. In amateur boxing, we simply count the punches. A knockdown counts the same as a jab. You'll see when you're watching these amateur bouts, you'll see the two-tone gloves with a white knuckle. And what the judges are looking for is for that boxer to score with a knuckle portion of his gloves in the scoring area, which is from the head to the waist with an imaginary line down the middle of the body excluding the arms. And if the punch is landed with on that knuckle surface with the weight of the shoulders behind it, the judge goes ahead and gives a point to that boxer without it, of course, being blocked or while the boxer is committing a foul. So sometimes people could watch amateur boxing and wonder how a kid could get 2 8 counts or a boxer get 3 and still win the bout. We're simply looking for scoring blows.
Boxing has the reputation of being a physical, even violent sport.
Getting kids involved at such an early age sounds a little risky, but as is to be expected, the primary concern of the officials in amateur boxing is safety.
I'm primarily a referee, is to make sure that the kids come out of the ring in one piece as they entered the ring. That's basically what we're here for, is safety in the sport. I'm looking for the head punches. Those are probably the most important thing that I'm looking for. If a kid's taking too many head punches, the headgear does not stop a boxer from receiving a punch on the chin, but it does stop the cuts that you see in professional boxing over the eyebrows. If they actually bump heads, it provides protection. If they suffer a knockdown, there's some padding behind the headgear. So I'm mainly focusing on the head more than any other part of the body.
With the safety issue well covered and the popularity of amateur boxing growing, quality officiating has given youth boxers and boxing a chance for a bright future. Rob Osmond, All-Star Valley Sports.
Double pastrami burger from Carl's Jr. because delis don't have drive-thrus.
The Carl's Jr. Time Warner Cable Game of the Week is brought to you by Carl's Jr. When it comes to big, juicy, charbroiled burgers, the name of the game is Carl's Jr. Welcome back to the Spotlight Showroom at Trump 29 Casino for the Carl's Jr. Time Warner Cable Game of the Week and the third annual Desert Showdown. About to get underway now is a bout for 132-pounders, 15 and 16 years old. An open division, and this is a semifinal. The winner here goes into the finals. Out of the blue corner, Antonio Moya, who's a host out of Fist of Gold Gym out of Los Angeles. And his opponent in the red corner is Anthony Chavez. He's out of the Stockton Police Activity Leagues. And right now we are getting ready for the ring introductions from our referee in charge, and that is Zach Young out of East Los Angeles. And as soon as we get an introduction for the ring, we will be off and running. This is an open division, and that means that both these fighters are quite established. So round number one, just about to get underway for this semifinal bout. Checking the referees, they're ready to go and off and running. Here we are in round number one. Antonio Moyo is in the maroon. And already trouble. Good tough exchange going on now. Moya is in the maroon colors and Anthony Chavez is the black top in the white shorts. And now Antonio Moya with a tough exchange. And Anthony Chavez finds himself the victim of a standing eight count. And here comes Antonio Moyle with the pressure. A diving stop, could not keep control of himself, so they'll stop it, break it apart. Chavez will have time to recover, and Moya continues with that left-hand jab lead and then following through with the combo. And now a shot from Chavez, and that's going to be tough to recover from. Tough exchange, and on the break, a left hook from Chavez. Both boxers now sizing each other up, knowing the potential of danger of slipping or leaving yourself open. These guys are both quite experienced. Looking for that opening. Advancing now, Antonio Moyo comes up empty in that. Of quick jab and then a good flurry of punches. Tough exchange and a shot. A left-handed hook twice now has caught Anthony Chavez. And here comes Antonio Moyo. And now we're stopping the fight for a second and they're giving a caution to Anthony Chavez. And that will be the end of round number one. So being tended to. Now in the ring in the corner here with Antonio Moyo. And they're advising him exactly what needs to be done to counter and come back from all this. Antonio Moyo was all over Anthony Chavez from the Stockton Police Activity League. And Antonio Chavez is getting an earful from his instructor as to what exactly needs to be done. And just about now underway for round number two. Back underway now, and Antonio Moyo. Feeling the pressure now, and here comes Antonio Moyo with a haymaker from nowhere, and a tough exchange going on now here, a flurry of hooks. And a sharp right hook lands, catches Chavez. And then a big left hook, and that's going to be a standing A count against Chavez as he was caught by a left hook from Antonio Moyo, a fist of gold. And back to action we go, and Moyo is not pressing the action. And backing off now, settling down, then coming straight at him again is Moyo. And here we keep continuing here in round number two. Both boxers sizing each other up. Moyo with a couple of jabs. And now Moyo breaks away, and now he has Chavez in the corner. Chavez will get himself out of it and then come back charging with two swift jabs to back up Moyo. Back into the corner goes Chavez of his own free will, and now Moyo will press the issue. And flailing a couple jabs inside, and that will be the end of round number two. Where Antonio Moyo has the opportunity to keep pushing and keep going, and he keeps backing off and giving Chavez a little bit of life, and I'm sure that's exactly what his trainer is telling him, is that once he's got him on the ropes or once he exploits an opening, he needs to follow up on it and continue pushing it until he gets his way. On the other side of the ring, Anthony Chavez has been a victim of a couple of flurries from Antonio Moyo, and is doing a little bit of recoiling, and now coming into the third round, he's really gonna have to turn it on to make it happen. Otherwise, it looks like Antonio Moyo will have a easy victory into the finals. Final round is underway. Antonio Moyo, a fist of gold in the maroon, taking on Anthony Chavez from Stockton Police Activity League. Two very tough, experienced boxers, but Antonio Moyo is really setting the tempo and then finds overhand right that smashes into Chavez for yet another scoring blow. And he leads with that overhand right, And then when he follows, he's rocking Chavez in the corner now. About every third punch is landing and rocking Chavez's head back. Now Chavez makes a reverse, comes back with a hard right hand that knocks Moya's head back. And a caution now for Chavez as things settle down here in the third round. And here we come with Antonio Moya. Pushing his way in. Chavez fakes the go-around, comes back for a sucker punch, and Moya would have no part of it.
Bout number 25 on your program, 145 pounds, 15 to 16, novice.
And now the coach of Antonio Moya has been asked to leave the side. Zach Young getting an earful and not appreciating it, so on we go. Round three, the final round wrapping up for these 132-pounders. Tough exchange for Chavez. And Antonio is continuing his pursuit. So all of a sudden, this one has taken kind of a turn that could go either way, even though it appears Antonio Moya, a fist of gold, is doing the pushing and is clearly the dominating effort. And now a hook shot goes off the ring, and that will be the end of round number three of what turned out to be a fairly hotly contested 132-pound open semifinal for 15 and 16-year-olds. And a very difficult battle. We are going to take a quick break. We'll come back with our decision. You're watching the Carl's Jr. Time Warner Cable Game of the Week. And we will be right back right after this.
When your hectic life is in fast forward, you can stop time with Time Warner Digital Cable for the time of your life. Get the most from digital cable and Roadrunner High Speed Online. With this back-to-school special, start your favorite movies the instant you want with eye control. Pause, rewind, or fast forward using your digital remote whenever you want. Choose from hundreds of channels with more premium channels than satellite. And the same digital cable gives you two great connections at the same time. With Roadrunner High Speed Online, you're always connected. Download photos, video, and music up to 50 times faster than dial-up. Make shopping a joy. And with these special savings, now is the time to get digital cable from Time Warner. Get half off any DigiPick or DigiPick combo package for the first 2 months. And when you order now, installation is only $9.95. Time Warner Cable. Now anything's possible.
The Thermal Boxing Club and Desert Showdown would like to thank Faultline Screen Printing for their contributions to amateur boxing. For custom t-shirts, printing, graphics, and embroidery, it's Faultline Screen Printing, proud sponsors of the 2004 Desert Showdown.
Welcome back to the Carl's Jr. Time Warner Cable Game of the Week from Trump 29 Casino and the Spotlight Showroom. We're awaiting the decision of the 132-pound class, 15 and 16-year-olds, open category. This is a semifinal. Out of the blue corner, Antonio Moya, out of Fist of Gold, Jim, in a battle against Anthony Chavez from Stockton Police Activity League, and we're about to find out who the winner is. Just waiting for the announcement any minute now. Zach Young will raise the winner.
And they look like world-class boxers. At this time, we have to announce a winner, and we will do so.
And that announcement is being made as we speak, and we'll find out who is going to go to the finals, and it's going to be Antonio Moya from Fists of Gold advancing. So the earlier success that Moya had paid off dividends to take him into the final round, or the final bout of this tournament. So a good job from Antonio Moya. Lots more fights coming up. You're watching the Carl's Jr. Time Warner Cable Game of the Week from Trump 29 Casino. And we will be right back right after these messages.
Hi, I'm Denny Marks from Contact One. My goal is to help you promote your business without saying a word. We have everything from clever, innovative products to office products that your clients use every day, all with your logo to make a distinct impression. We have a wide variety of promotional products, from sporting goods to beautiful gift baskets for special occasions. If you can think about it, we can logo it. Check our extensive website at contactpp.com today for some great ideas.
Welcome back to the Carl's Jr. Time Warner Cable Game of the Week from the beautiful Spotlight Showroom at Trump 29 Casino. Rob Osmond with you with All-Star Entertainment Productions in the third annual Desert Showdown. Coming up, we've got a battle of 119-pounders in the novice division, a semifinal in the red corner. Ramon Serratos from Eddie Heredia Boxing Club taking on Eric Ledesma in the blue corner. Out of Calipatria, Eric Ledesma has the white trunks, and Ramon Serratos has the black trunks.
Ladies and gentlemen, call your attention to ring number two.
And this has been a highly contested weight class. These are novices, so they have fought less than 10 times.
Your winner, and moving to the finals in tomorrow's Desert Showdown.
But they are underway. And sizing each other up nicely. Nobody coming out ahead. Eric Ledesma has an uppercut that may have caught Ramon Serratos.
Ladies and gentlemen, I have a correction. The winner is out of the blue corner.
And a very good exchange going on now.
The night is getting along.
As Ramon Serratos continues to back away and then fire those sharp little jabs. Eric Ledesma is working very hard with his short jabs, trying to find his mark, unable to do so. May have landed a body shot and then comes up with an uppercut left, and now continually working the body. It's a smart tactic for Eric Ledesma. Now doing a little defensive backpedaling as Ramon Serratos continues to fire those short little punches that find their mark and score points. If you want to win in amateur boxing, it's a matter of points. You get no points for style, no points for knockdowns, no points for blood. The only thing you get points for is putting the white part of the glove on the scoring area. And a sharp right hand, a sharp left hand, followed by a sharp right hand from Ramon Serratos, and that will call an end to round number one. There is a lot of confusion, in all fairness. We may have seen a late blow from Eric Ledesma. There are three rings going on, so each fighter may have fought in other rings, and they listen to different sounds that tell you when to start and stop fighting. And if you're not paying attention to the noise around you, if you're paying attention solely on the fight, you can get hit with a late bell or a late shot at the bell, or you can throw a punch that would best have been held. So either way, Ramon Serratos from Eddie Heredia is holding his own against Eric Ledesma. Eric Ledesma at a Calipatria Boxing Club being tended to. Both fighters show good form considering they're novices. And round number two about to get underway. Again, Ramon Serratos is wearing the black trunks and Eric Ledesma is wearing the white. So Ramon, a little more lively it appears in the early going here of the second round. Looking for his mark. Taking a jab from Eric Ledesma that went for points and then missing on his own with a right cross. Second round, very pivotal. A lot of fighters run out of gas in the second round and then they only lose it in the third because they never get it back. So it's a matter of pacing yourself, but you've got to keep boxing. You've got to be in good enough conditioning to make it. And now Ramon snaps the head back of Eric Ledesma with a jab that had a little bit of force on it. And continues to be the sharper of the boxers, landing again with a sharp left jab. That's fine against Mark. So Ramon Serratos has settled down, gotten past the first round jitters, if you will, and is starting to go to work on Eric Ledesma. Missing with a pair of right hooks. As Ledesma's able to get himself out of trouble. And Ledesma wailing away, but so far has not found his mark in round number two. And I think we're going to have an equipment check. Now the coach, the trainer in the red corner, in Ramon Serrano's corner, is being asked to leave. Coaches are not allowed to speak or coach during the fight. They'll get one warning from the referee, and the second will be a toss. And the referee making sure that he gets far enough away where he doesn't have to hear him. And that's the control that has to be made. It has to be taken during these fights. Things can get out of hand quickly. It's a very aggressive sport. And even as a spectator, you can get wrapped up in it. But it's amateur boxing after all. It's for a good cause. Keep the kids fighting in the ring, not out of it. As Eric Ledesma gets a parting blow in on Ramon Serratos as round number two comes to an end. Where we saw Ramon Serratos right here in the red corner start to find his groove. He got into a little bit of good movement going on, showed some good moves and threw some good punches. And is, if he is ahead by any stretch of the imagination, it is just because of that. He's landed some crisp jabs that are good scoring points. Eric Ledesma on the other side of the ring is holding his own. No fighter has been able to separate himself, but Eric Ledesma is finding himself at a point where he could be just behind or even. So he will definitely want to pick it up here in round number three. And that could have been his strategy, to kind of just lay low in round number two and then come out and explode in round number three. Either way, we're about to find out as round number three is off and running in this battle of 119 pounders in the novice category for 17 to 35 year olds. The senior division, they call it. And right back to work goes Ramon Serratos. Eric Ledesma is playing a game of catch, and he's trying to catch Ramon Serratos. Serratos making the most out of all the ring. Ledesma giving chase and then walking into a series of jabs from Ramon Serratos. Ramon Serratos again with those crisp jabs. I mean, his hooks are rarely landing. His uppercuts occasionally find their mark, but for the most part, it's his jab that's earning Ramon Serratos the points. Eric Ledesma is getting points from both, from working inside and then occasionally going to the outside for points. But it's the inside battle that's going to win it for you. Unless you can continue. A sharp series of punches there by Eric Ledesma, and Ramon Serratos knew it. Got that jab, and now Eric Ledesma is finding the inside track a little bit easier. As Ramon Serratos lands an overhand left jab that caught Ledesma. And now a good exchange going. Both fighters shortening up their swings in this third round. Not going to the big punch unless there's an opening. And so far there have been few. Just a good series of fundamental boxing going on right now. And that makes it a little difficult to get a victory out of. As the fight comes to a close, and it's going to be a close one, it'll come down to the decision. as both fighters put on a good show of short little jabs and very few hooks landing for points. So we'll find out the decision after we take a quick break. You're watching the Carl's Jr. Time Warner Cable Game of the Week from the Spotlight Showroom at Trump 29 Casino. And we will be right back with a decision right after this.
For the best in local high school sports, it's the Carl's Jr. Time Warner Cable Game of the Week. Brought to you by All-Star Entertainment Productions and Time Warner Cable. Broadcast weekly beginning Fridays at 11 p.m. only on Channel 10. Throughout the school year, catch all the action and excitement of high school sports as teams compete for a CIF playoff spot.
The Thermal Boxing Club and Desert Showdown would like to thank Tidal Boxing Equipment for their support of amateur boxing. Tidal Boxing Equipment, if we don't have it, you don't need it. Online at www.tidalboxing.com. Tidal Boxing Equipment, proud sponsors of the 2004 Desert Showdown. Welcome back to the Carl's Jr. Time Warner Cable Game of the Week. Rob Austin with you with All-Star Entertainment Productions, about to get the results of a 119-pound battle of seniors, 17 to 35-year-old novices in a semifinal. In the blue corner, Eric Ledesma, and in the red corner, Ramon Serratos. Which one will go to the finals? We are about to find out.
Senior novice semifinal. Your winner is standing in the red corner.
And it is indeed Ramon Serratos. A great job of boxing for Serratos. And those sharp, crisp jabs will win it for you almost every time. They rack up the points in a hurry. Well, we have more boxing coming up. We'll take a quick break. We'll come back with it all from Spotlight Showroom at Trump 29 Casino on the Carl's Jr. Time Warner Cable Game of the Week.
Anyone want to trade?
Spending too much time at the deli? The new double pastrami burger from Carl's Jr. Without us, some guys would starve.
This portion of the Carl's Jr. Time Warner Cable Game of the Week is brought to you in part by QT School Uniforms and Embroidery, providing quality professional work and school uniforms for the Coachella Valley. All-Star Entertainment Productions is proud to welcome QT Uniforms to the Game of the Week family. Welcome back to the Carl's Jr. Time Warner Cable Game of the Week from the Spotlight Showroom at the beautiful Trump 29 Casino. Rob Osmond with you with All-Star Entertainment Productions. Coming up next, we have a Coachella Valley fighter taking on, out of Los Angeles, a boxer at 125 pounds, Jose Castellanos, out of Coachella Boxing Club. In the red corner, in the 17 to 35 pound category, novice. This is a semi-final fight. His opponent is out of De La Hoya Boxing Club. And Jose Castellanos has already got himself a good fan support. Roberto Rios from De La Hoya Boxing Club is the opponent.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, ready for bout number
Roberto
four,
Rios, out of the blue corner, is wearing a white shirt and white trunks. And Jose Castellanos from Coachella is wearing black. Introductions being made as we speak. And like I said, Jose Castellanos has himself quite the following. And Roberto Rios getting his introduction. Again, it's a semifinal battle. They call it the senior division, 17 to 35 novice category, meaning both these fighters have fought less than 10 times. And we are just about to get underway once the officials know exactly who's who. And now it looks like things have settled down and we are just about underway as chants of Jose are coming around the crowd as they are filling in here. Round number one is underway. Jose Castillo with a hard left hand right away to set the tone of the tempo and then firing an uppercut to the midsection of Rios. And I tell you, Castellanos is coming out like a firecracker. Hot pursuit, a flurry of punches against the rope. Left hook lands. To the body he goes, Castellanos. And a sharp left hand rocks the head back of Roberto Rios. And Jose Castellanos is pouring it on in the first round. Solid body shot, and Rios is in trouble early on. He gives up a huge height advantage, Castellanos does. Rios is quite tall and has some reach on him, but I tell you, Castellanos has found a way early to get inside and get some points with some hard shots. And Rios is doing well to recover from that. Another overhand right lands from Castellanos. He's able to slip through the reach of Roberto Rios. Rios comes up with an uppercut that may have scored and then reaches in with a body shot. But Castellanos is just pouring it on, picking his way through, launching a fury of attacks, and most of those punches landed for points back in that corner. So Jose Castellanos is setting a feverish pace here in round number one and is racking up the points. And now things have kind of settled down as that fury goes and Roberto Rios trying to counter. And then a sharp left hand. Rios catches him on the chin and down goes Castellanos. Castellanos was stung earlier by a right cross from Roberto Rios. And then the second time it caught him, sent Castellanos to the ground and we are back underway. And now, bringing it on and pouring it on is Roberto Rios, and the referee will stop the contest. So just when you thought Roberto Rios was in big trouble, and now they're saying they did not stop the fight. The fight was not stopped. The round ended. So even Roberto Rios thought he had won that fight already. It was stopped so quickly. But they've got their hands full over in the red corner. In the blue corner, Roberto Rios was in real trouble early and put it together to survive the round and even go so far as to put Jose Castellanos, rather, on the verge of losing this bout. And that's going to be tough to recover from. Castellanos showing a little bit of red, where he was stung by a very sharp left hook that sent him to the canvas. He was actually hit by the same punch twice. And it looks like Jose Castellanos is on his feet. We'll see if he has enough to recover from it. And here comes Roberto Rios out of De La Jolla Boxing Club.
Representing the Bella Chavez Boxing Center out of Carson, California. And the red corner.
And we are underway in the second round, and we'll see if Roberto Rios continues his onslaught. Both fighters now going to the slugging, and this is where it becomes dangerous because you land a good sharp punch, and now we're going to stop it. Break it up a little bit, getting a little bit out of hand, and a standing eight count now being given to Roberto Rios. So these two sluggers are just going at it in the best exchange so far, and they're throwing these wild, hard punches. And when the danger of doing that is you leave yourself open to get clocked, and now it's happened on both sides. And now it's Castellanos turning the table, pouring it on, backing up Rios, and we'll see if Rios can recover from this, and he does. He's got Castellanos back against the rope, flailing away. Castellanos takes one hard across the chin, and then bounces back and explodes at Rios. And these guys are just not gonna let up. Blood now showing from Rios. And all over it is Castellanos, but Castellanos is in trouble himself. And these guys, sooner or later, are going to run out of gas. Rios goes back through the ropes. They'll stop it momentarily, and they go right back at it in a hard left by Castellanos. Castellanos landing that left hook. A solid shot. And a little wobbly on his legs is Roberto Rios, and one good shot, you get the feeling he's going to go down as he's back on his heels. And now, so is Castellanos. Castellanos is probably out of gas. Both these guys slugging away, a lot of power and not much form. But one of those punches slips through and everyone's in trouble here. Back and forth it goes. Castellanos was against the rope, turns the table, and now the referee is going to stop things, slow it down just a little bit, caution both fighters. They'll catch their breath and come right back at it. A hard overhand right by Rios rocks Castellanos. Referee stopping it again, trying to cool things down, and now they're still boxing. Everyone thought the round was over. And punching right through the defense of Castellanos, Rios landed two jabs really quick at the end of round number two. I tell you, the crowd is getting into it. The fighters can't hear the bell. The referee can't hear the whistle. And we've got ourselves a war here at the 125-pound novice senior division, 17 to 35-year-olds. And this one is living up to all the billing it had. Castellanos now trying to catch his breath. He's got it together. Now on the other side in the blue corner, Roberto Rios, we saw him a little wobbly in the legs. And when you throw a fury of punches like that, it takes a lot of energy out of you. And he's having difficulty catching his breath, so we're going to see if Roberto Rios, who had a first round knockdown and then got himself a standing eight count, the crowd now is pumping Jose Castellanos from Coachella up. And they are really getting into it here at Trump 29 Casino.